On Wednesday, officials of the National Hospital Insurance Fund appeared before the Health Committee to issue a report on its budget implementation between 2018 and the first quarter of the 2019-2020 financial year. NHIF taken to task to explain why it was eating into its surplus funds.
At the rate you are going, you brought in some benefit packages which are bleeding the fund. And if we continue this way, you are headed down. In fact, left in the state you are in another 3-4 years, you'll be completely in the red.
In terms of what we are doing as an NHIF to try to control the high expenditure, we do them through what we call the pre-authorization, so that the hospitals do not just decide what to do. And those pre-authorization requests have to be done by specialists in those specific areas, so that approval is done before the treatment is made.
In the 2018-2019 financial year, the National Insurer paid out benefits amounting to 37.72 billion shillings against an annual budget of 32.11 billion shillings.
As we know, Ministry of Health today disqualified and nullified and closed down 800 plus. It's not a small number as far as our country, Kenya, is concerned. It is close to 1,000 facilities, government-owned facilities. How NHIF accredited them when the same ministry feels that it is not, it's fraudulism, number one. Number two, how we paid them, how much money NHIF paid these fraudulent facilities.
We have to wait. If the license has been taken back, then the medical board will inform the fund, and that is when we shall go back to deal with them. So we are dealing with that in terms of the contract provision.
A huge bulk of claims were paid out to private hospitals where a large number of members are seeking treatment. NHIF is calling for a review of the 500 shillings paid by members under the super cover, saying it may prove unsustainable in the long term. Currently, 8.4 million Kenyans are insured under NHIF, with the formal sector accounting for 51% of the figures. In 2018, delivery accounted for 11% of the total budget, followed by renal failure at 10%, with protozoal diseases accounting for 9% of the claims.